Hey everyone, my name is Miss Autumn with the Boys and Girls Club of Greater St. Louis, and today we are going to be learning about advertisement techniques. The power of advertising is its ability to persuade, and companies have a lot of techniques that they use when they are creating a message to broadcast to the public. Advertising is a multi-million dollar business, and its sole purpose is to convince you to buy a product. So they have to use these techniques to persuade you to buy that product or to behave in a certain way. Today, you'll learn about 15 common techniques that can be found in almost any ad that you see. You'll learn the terminology and see how these ads encourage consumerism. By the end of the lesson, you should come away with the knowledge needed to become more informed consumers. But before we get to that, I want to do a warm-up with you guys. I want you to think of an ad that you have seen or heard recently. What was it about that ad that made you remember it? Was it the visuals? Was there a catchy song attached to it? Was it the acting? Or was there someone in it that you know? Now that you've thought of the ad, tell me, did you buy the product described in the ad? Or were you at least tempted to buy it? Why? If you bought the product or was even tempted to buy the product, then the advertisement did its job. And I bet they used at least one of the techniques that I'm going to cover today to convince you to buy that product. So let's go ahead and go over those techniques and see what they look like so that you can become more aware of them in the future. The basic ad. This is the simplest message. The ad just tells people to buy the product, and the hope is that if you've seen and heard the ad often enough, you may purchase it the next time you shop. For example, this IKEA ad literally has nothing on it besides the name of the company, the price, and the item being advertised. IKEA is hoping that the people that see the ad are either immediately in the market for this thing or will be soon and will remember the ad when they go out to buy it. Eye appeal. The ad suggests how good something tastes, for example, junk food, alcohol, or cigarettes, by showing people enjoying it. Often, a clever perspective will be used to make the product look glamorous. Take a look at this Dove chocolate ad.
Only a chocolate this pure can be this silky and make you savor, sigh, melt. Dove Pure Silk Chocolate, now with the tantalizing crunch of almond. My moment, my Dove.
Notice how they used words that enticed your senses while making you watch a woman enjoy the product. Happy family appeal. This technique is used to convince you that the product can bring joy to your family. So, you might see a mother in the ad assure mothers in the viewing audience, your family will be happy and healthy if you buy this product. Or you'll hear, if you want to show how much you love your wife, give her this product. Look at this sneaker ad whose main line is nothing compares to family. The message is that happy, cohesive families wear Skechers, and that you should buy Skechers if you want your family to look like this. Experts say. A golfer should know about golf balls. A chef is an expert about food. People usually trust experts. When the American Dental Society says that Crest toothpaste helps prevent tooth decay, Crest becomes the best-selling toothpaste in the country. Sometimes the ad will use fake experts, like an actor who plays a doctor on TV to advertise headache medicine to sell their product, like this Colgate ad.
It's like having fuzzy slippers on your teeth, but the real word for it is plaque, and that news came straight from the dentist. His advice, switch to Colgate Total.
When I saw a little pink in the sink, I thought, I'm just brushing too hard, no big deal. Then the dentist said a little bleeding is a sign of gingivitis and to switch to Colgate Total.
Only Colgate Total has an antibacterial ingredient. It attaches to teeth to form a protective shield that's clinically proven to protect against a complete range of oral health problems for a full 12 hours. No other toothpaste can do that. Only Colgate Total reduces plaque by up to 98% and gingivitis by up to 88%.
Clean. Even right after lunch, the plaque didn't come back.
My gums are healthier, stronger.
I recommend it because I saw results. Colgate Total has complete 12-hour protection.
For a free product trial, visit colgatetotal.com/offer. Colgate Total, number one recommended by dental professionals. Complete 12-hour protection.
Famous people say. When a famous person says they like a product, viewers or readers may choose to follow their example. A sports star knows more about sports than we do, but what do they know about cereal or cologne? Nothing really, but they're hoping that they can convince you that it's worth having if all your favorite celebrities buy it. Like this Sprite ad with Drake.
Yo, what's up?
I'm just not feeling it.
Snob appeal. This technique caters to people's desire to be, or at least look and feel, rich. It wants to persuade a consumer to purchase a product or service by convincing them that the purchase will elevate their status. Look at this cologne commercial. Take note how the commercial is trying to connect fame to the product. Youth appeal. Many ads are aimed at the youth market and at older people who want to look and feel young. Youth are one of the primary demographics that advertisers target. Not only do young people buy a lot of things, they often persuade their parents to purchase particular products or brands. Like this Coca-Cola commercial that primarily uses young people and has the narrator speaking about being young.
What an amazing adventure. I can't believe we went the places we did.
All right.
The beautiful sunset on the parkway. I still can't believe I jumped off that cliff. And even through the thick and thin.
Really?
I wouldn't have it any other way. A toast to our youth. Friendship, which can't be counted in currency, but only measured in memory. The good, the bad, these are the memories we'll remember for the rest of our lives. Cheers.
Symbols. By now we all associate the Golden Arches with McDonald's fast food. The Nike swoosh logo has become so familiar that some Nike ads use few, if any, other words or images. The Apple used for Apple computers and iPhone products translates for many as the latest and coolest in technology. This technique relies on social perceptions to carry the product. Everybody likes. The message is, get on the bandwagon. Our product is so popular and you should like it too. Don't be left out. Crowds of people might be shown smiling as they use the product. It makes the consumer feel as if they're the only ones holding out, and if they join everyone else, they'll be happier. Like this Apple ad that's basically saying, buy this phone, and you'll love it just like everyone else does. New and improved. This technique is used to attract attention to an already established product, and the ad may focus on a new and often non-essential feature, like a differently shaped package or a new and improved flavor. For example, this McDonald's ad claims that they've made this product better than ever, so you just have to try it, right? The humble approach. Another way to sell is to admit that the company or the product is not the best or the biggest. For example, Domino's did an entire campaign back in 2008 trying to convince its customers to try their new pizza. They called it the Pizza Turnaround and released commercials where Domino's employees held focus groups and took public criticism and then used that to claim that they improved the quality of their product for the customers.
There comes a time when you know you've got to make a change.
Pizza, where's the love? How hard? Bread, sauce, cheese, fresh ingredients. Doesn't feel like there's much love in Domino's pizza.
Domino's pizza crust to me is like cardboard.
Is it hard to watch this stuff? Is this
Yeah, it's hard to watch.
I hear what some folks are saying about our stuff.
Oh, this one's bad. Worst excuse for pizza I've ever had.
The sauce tastes like ketchup.
Totally void of flavor.
You know what? When you first hear it, it's shocking.
The cardboard complaint is the most common one.
This we hear over and over and over.
I mean, that hits you right in the heart. This is what we've done. This is what I've done, you know, for 25 years now.
You can either use negative comments to get you down, or you can use them to excite you and energize your process of making a better pizza. We did the latter.
Most companies hide the criticism that they're getting, and we actually faced it head on.
Some people didn't get us credit for the taste of our product. That's what we're fixing.
We listen to our consumers, and they want us to be better, and we want them to be happier. We want people to love our pizza.
This is what's driving us. This is what's lit the fire under us. This is what's making us want to get better.
Who are we?
Domino's Pizza!
Statistics. Companies use numbers to enhance the perception of their product. While images are good for attention and aesthetics, the statistics technique relies less on the visuals and more on the numbers themselves. For example, companies can say that they took a survey to find out how many people liked the product, and then they use those figures to persuade other people to buy their product. Or they can use the numbers to compare themselves to other brands and make themselves look better, like this Nestle ad. Concern for the public good. We don't pollute the air. We keep kids from dropping out of school. We're investing in our country's future. The message is that people should have faith in the product of a company that is obviously civic-minded. Does Nike really care about equality? We'll never know, but this commercial really makes it seem like they do.
Is this the land history promised? Here, within these lines. On this concrete court, this patch of turf, here you're defined by your actions, not your looks or beliefs. Equality should have no boundaries. The bonds we find here should run past these lines.
It's been a long time coming.
Opportunity should not discriminate. The ball should bounce the same for everyone.
Change gonna come.
Worth should outshine color.
equals everywhere.
Sex appeal. A romantic message is often used in ads for cosmetics, mouthwashes, clothing, and automobiles. The ad suggests that people will be more attractive or more popular if they use the product. Clothing stores like Victoria's Secret are great at these kinds of ads.
They can trick you, but you've got to save me. Take a bite of you, come play with me.
Humor. Some funny commercials have become famous. The Got Milk campaign of the dairy industry, with its milk mustache celebrities gracing magazine ads and TV commercials, is a good example. Such comic ads often give a product nationwide recognition, like this Sprint ad.
I just got a text from you that you're breaking up with me.
Don't worry about that. I switched to Sprint's $69.99 plan, so I wasn't charged extra.
Okay, I just got your breakup email.
Emails are unlimited too. And look, I just changed my Facebook status to single, but internet's also unlimited.
Yeah.
Only Sprint gives you unlimited text, web, and calling to any mobile for just $69.99. Sprint, the Now Network.
So those are all of the techniques. Becoming aware of these trick-like techniques used to sell products helps the consumer think more critically about the product's usefulness or features. It prevents them from reacting impulsively or emotionally to an ad and prevents them from spending money on a product that may disappoint them or that the consumer really doesn't need or want. Now we're going to see how well you can identify these techniques on your own. I'm going to show an ad and you must choose the correct answer on what type of technique is being used in that ad.
This bud's for the blues, the reds, and the warriors. This bud's for the magic, the athletics, the giants, and the jazz. This bud's for the trailblazers, the Braves, the Yankees, and the Angels. This bud's for the home team.
Which technique is this? Sex appeal, concern for public good, basic ad, or youth appeal? This commercial uses concern for public good. You might be seeing a lot of these ads right now that are trying to convince you that companies' primary focus is protecting customers and workers, but they're just trying to convince you to support their products during this time. Which technique is this? Famous people say, experts say, snob appeal, or new and improved? This ad uses famous people say. Even though Kevin Durant isn't saying he uses Gatorade products, it shows him using the products to help in crucial moments in hopes that you reach for the same products in those moments.
Say hello to the all-new Echo. It's everything you love about Echo with a brand new look and a brand new price. Echo connects to Alexa to play music, call friends and family, control smart home devices, and more. And because Alexa is in the cloud, she's always getting smarter and adding new features. Echo comes in 6 unique styles designed to blend in or stand out. And with speakers powered by Dolby, it can fill any room with crisp vocals and rich bass. 7 microphones help Echo and Alexa hear you from any direction, even when music is playing. All you have to do is ask.
Which technique is this? New and improved, snob appeal, statistics, or humble approach? This ad uses the new and improved technique. The ad immediately begins by pointing out the new features that this product has over previous versions, so that anyone that had any concerns about the old version would be convinced to buy this one.
Beauty secrets from celebrity makeup artist Bruce Grayson.
People ask me for little beauty secrets all the time, and this is what I always tell them. Great makeup starts with great skincare. That's why I'm a big believer in Olay Definity Color Recapture.
New Definity Color Recapture. Now the power of Olay Anti-Aging Moisturizer that goes beyond wrinkles to fight age spots and discoloration meets the instant sheer illuminating coverage of foundation.
You get the real fix of Definity to help diminish the look of discoloration and wrinkles with a quick fix of flawless foundation coverage. Something that makes your skin look so good won't stay a secret for long.
Definity Color Recapture comes in 3 unique tones and is designed to work with the entire Definity lineup. Olay guarantees you'll love it or your money back. Instant coverage and anti-aging treatment in one. A double way to recapture younger looking skin. Go online for a $5 coupon and definitely love the skin you're in.
Which technique does this ad use? Famous people say, everybody likes, experts say, or youth appeal? This ad uses experts say. By using someone who's considered a beauty expert, the commercial is hoping to convince you that they know what's best for you, which is this product.
Quiet and action. Let's get one thing straight. I never tell you to drink Sprite, even if I was in a commercial for Sprite, which I am, or you were watching it, which you are. I wouldn't tell you to drink it. No matter what that cue card says.
Bro, man, say it.
No. Even if you just eating tacos with extra hot sauce, and you were holding an extra cold Sprite, and for some reason, you're waiting for me to tell you to drink it, I still wouldn't tell you to drink that thirst-quenching Sprite. Even if this were a metaphor about Sprite, and I was talking about Sprite, and little Yachty here was paid by Sprite to write lyrics about Sprite. Call like a Sprite soda. Call like a Sprite soda. I still wouldn't tell you to drink Sprite. And even if all these cool influencer people were holding one, I still wouldn't tell you to drink a cool, crisp, refreshing lemon-lime Sprite. I'd ask you, you want a Sprite?
Which technique does this ad use? Famous people say, symbols, eye appeal, or humor? This is actually a trick question. A lot of companies try to mix in multiple techniques in their ads. This ad with LeBron James can be seen as both famous people say, because it shows both LeBron James and Lil Yachty, and humor, because it's trying to use being funny to make the ad stand out.
So, in conclusion, if we know what the false message is, or we know the psychology behind the ad and what the advertisers are trying to convince you to do, you can resist being manipulated into buying or doing something that isn't right for you. Take a look at the clothing you're wearing or the items that you most often carry around with you, like your backpack or your cell phone. Are you participating in advertising for any company by wearing items with brand names displayed prominently, and by default spreading the message of those brands? As a wrap up, I want you guys to reflect on how today's lesson has led you to become a more sophisticated consumer. Think about how you might spend your money differently now that you know the different techniques that companies use to get you to buy their products. That's going to be all for today. If you have any questions, you can email us at gotquestions@bgcstl.org, or you can comment on our Facebook page or our Twitter page. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of your day.